I want to conclude this two-part series of videos looking at aspect in English by looking at the perfect. Last time we looked at the progressive, and there are two aspects in English, the second being the perfect. In the last video, I made the point that tense and aspect are two very different beasts, two different ways of looking at events and situations, tense being more time related, but aspect connoting a particular perspective, if you like, an aspect, a point of view. And that a structure like the present perfect, for example, is not a tense as such. It has a tense in it, the present bit, but the perfect adds something extra. And I want to look at what that extra is. It's worth pointing out that the presentness of the present perfect in sentences like "Your taxi has arrived," or "They've been married for 10 years," is fairly obvious. The implication being, in the case of the first, that the taxi is still here. There's present evidence, and the second that they are still married. So there is a clear presentness about those two examples. But with the addition of this kind of what's sometimes called retrospective view, this is the aspect, the way of looking. So from a point in the present, we're looking back to the event of the taxi arriving, which is connected to the present by its virtue, its being still here, or the whole period that they have been married, starting from a point in the past 10 years ago and stretching up to the present. So this is what's sometimes called, as I say, the kind of retrospective view that is encoded in perfect aspect. Frank Palmer, this wonderful book came out 1965, sums it up quite neatly when he says that a period of time that includes the present is chosen precisely because there are features of the present that directly link it to the past activity. The features of the present that link the taxi to its arrival are the fact that it's still here, and the features of the present that link their marriage to the period of time they have been married is the fact that they're still married. So this notion of present evidence or present relevance is not that difficult to get your head around. The problem comes with examples like "I've been to China," which clearly relates to a past event, which no longer continues to the present. And this is often in textbooks analyzed separately as if there is another use altogether of the present perfect, which refers to indefinite past time. But I think there's a common element here that the fact that I've been to China occurs in a period that started in the past and continues up into the present. And it gives me the authority to talk about China. This is the present relevance, even though I'm not there, it is still relevant to me because it's part of my existing experience. So we're still talking essentially about the same period of time, the period of time that's seen retrospectively from the present, or in the case of the past perfect, from a point in the past, he had been to China, seen retrospectively from the point where he said that. He said he had been to China. And this can be demonstrated fairly easily in examples like, for example, Jack Nicholson has made 50 films compared to Heath Ledger made 10 films. The reason why we cannot use the present perfect in the case of Heath Ledger is that, regrettably, Heath Ledger is dead, and therefore there is a disconnect from the present. We cannot talk about this filmmaking period stretching up unto the present, whereas with Jack Nicholson, at least while he remains alive, we can say he has made 50 films because we're talking about a period that stretches up into the present. And these kinds of examples, I think, are good for showing students that even though Heath Ledger's films are more recent and Heath Ledger is younger than Jack Nicholson. The disconnect from the present means that we are, in a sense, compelled to use the past tense, the remote form, if you like. And these are good examples for showing students who might otherwise think there is, you know, the choice is arbitrary, that no, the choice is not arbitrary. In this case, it's a matter of life and death.